With us is Senator Bernie Sanders. Senator Sanders, welcome back to the program.
Great to be with you, Tom, and congratulations on all the great work you do day after day, year after year.
Well, thank you, and congratulations on how well you and your campaign are doing here in the in this primary. I'm wondering, first of all, you know, Bill Barr testifying before the Senate today, and in many cases it seems, according to Pat Leahy anyway, filibustering and being deceptive. I wonder what your thoughts are on the Attorney General.
I think Leahy is absolutely right. I mean, what you're looking at is a kind of unique situation where the administration, through Barr, are refusing to give the information that the American people are entitled to have through the Congress. So I think he is stonewalling, and we have a right to know.
Yesterday, I understand in the Senate there were hearings on Medicare for All. I missed those, but I know this is a big issue for you. In fact, you're the one who really turned it into a national issue. What happened, and what are your thoughts on it?
Well, it's interesting. It's a big issue for me, but I think it's a big issue for the American people, Tom. And you know that we remain the only major country on earth not to guarantee health care to all people. You got 34 million people without any health insurance, yet even more who are underinsured. We pay by far the highest prices in the world for prescription drugs. While the drug companies make billions in profit, one out of five Americans can't even afford the high prices that they're forced to pay. So I think, and the American people, I think, increasingly believe that the time is now to end private insurance domination over the healthcare system in America and move toward a Medicare for All healthcare system. Medicare now works quite well for seniors. No reason why it shouldn't be expanded to every man, woman, and child in this country. And when we do that, we end the absurdity of spending twice as much per capita on healthcare as do the people of any other nation. You're a family of four today, self-employed. You're spending $28,000 a year for healthcare, and the costs are soaring. And we have every single year, we're wasting many hundreds of billions of dollars on administrative costs, on billing, on excessive salaries for CEOs, and so forth. So I think the American people want to see us move to a Medicare for All. We have legislation in, which I would implement as president, to cut the cost of prescription drugs in this country in half so that we are paying the same prices that people around the world are paying. So this is a big deal, Tom, and we're going to stay on it.
What are your thoughts on you know, I've seen now a half a dozen times just in this last week commentators and even hosts on, you know, supposedly progressive television networks calling this proposal Medicare for All and many of the other proposals that Democrats are talking about as full-blown socialism, and it's going to turn us into the Soviet Union and all this kind of stuff.
Look, here's what we got, and I want people to appreciate this. What our campaign is now doing is taking on, obviously, Trump and the Republican establishment. We're taking on corporate America. But in terms of healthcare, we are taking on a new organization, which is being funded by the insurance companies and the drug companies. Now, if you were the head of United Healthcare and you made $83 million in compensation last year, you know what? You don't want a Medicare for All. You are the head of Aetna, which merged, as you know, with CVS, and you got a $500 million bonus for bringing about that merger. It's a gentleman named Mr. Bertolini, head of Aetna. You don't want a Medicare for All single-payer program, so you're going to come up with all kinds of stuff. Now, I live, and you used to live in Vermont, right? We bordered on Canada. Canada has had a single-payer system for decades now. Every other major country on earth has a variation. They're all a little bit different. Bottom line is all people get health care. Bottom line is private insurance companies do not make profits out of people's illness. Bottom line is that the cost of health care in all of those countries is significantly less. So you're going to hear all kinds of stuff. And a lot of the stuff comes from the many millions of dollars that the insurance companies and the drug companies are going to pour into this effort to defeat Medicare for All. But I got to tell you, I think we have the momentum here, and I think the healthcare industry is very, very nervous that we will end up doing what every other major country on earth does.
I think you've nailed it. I understand that you laid out a proposed change in our trade, and you and I have been talking about this for over a decade.
For a few years.
Yeah. So, you know, share the details with us.
Well, you know, one of the areas where Joe is a good friend of mine, and I know at the end of the day, no matter who wins the Democratic primary, we're all going to go forward together to defeat Trump. But, you know, Joe apparently repeated yesterday that he thought his vote for NAFTA was a good vote. He voted for permanent normal trade relations with China. You add those two trade agreements together, just those two trade agreements, it's a loss of over 4 million jobs in this country, where you have often profitable corporations shutting down in America because they don't want to pay workers here $15 or $20 an hour. They prefer to go to China or Mexico and pay people $1 or $2 an hour. And I think, you know, we have got to end that. And one of the areas, I think, where we have the government has a lot of leverage is to say to private corporations that if you want to shut down in America and go abroad, if you want to prevent your workers from joining a union, if you want to have salaries, CEOs making 300, 400, 500 times what your workers are making, you know what? You're not a good corporate citizen. And don't come around and ask for government contracts. So I think we have a lot of leverage on these corporations and tell them that they have got to stop their greed. I mean, what makes me sick to my stomach, and I have seen this time after time, and I think the American people are disgusted by this, is profitable corporations pay their CEOs outrageous levels of compensation. They're making all kinds of money. It's not like they're losing money. They shut down a plant or they tell workers you got to pay more for health care. We're not going to raise your wages. I mean, corporate America has been waging a massive anti-worker effort for decades now. And it is time to use the leverage of the federal government and say, you want a contract? That's great. Treat your workers with respect. And among other things, that means you're not going to shut down in this country when you're profitable and move abroad. So I think that's real leverage.